In this video, we will explain how to install the enterprise version of LiteSpeed Web Server in a cPanel WHM environment. Before we begin, you will need to have a server installed and configured with a cPanel WHM control panel and a working copy of Apache HTTP server. You will also need a fully qualified domain name pointing to the server. And lastly, you will need to open the following ports at the server level firewall: 22 for SSH, 7080, 80, and 443 for TCP, and 443 for UDP. Once these prerequisites are dealt with, we can dive into the following topics: disabling the Apache mod RUID2 module, removing Apache replacements or proxies, obtaining a license, installing LiteSpeed Web Server, and verifying LiteSpeed is running. Disabling Apache mod RUID2. LiteSpeed Enterprise does not support the mod RUID2 module, and it must be disabled. To disable mod RUID2, log into your cPanel WHM dashboard. Scroll down to the software section and click Easy Apache 4. Navigate to Currently Installed Packages, then Customize, and click Apache Modules. Search for Mod RUID2 and toggle the switch to uninstall the module. Click Review and click Provision. Removing replacements or proxies. Before installing LiteSpeed Web Server, you will need to remove any previous Apache replacements, like Nginx, or reverse proxies like Nginx over Apache or Nginx with Varnish. Click Server Status, then Service Status. Look at all of the services that are marked as up and verify that no proxies are running. You can also check HTTP header information through your browser's developer tools. Navigate to the Network tab and check the Response Header section. The server header should indicate Apache. Before installing LiteSpeed, you should make sure that the sites on your cPanel WHM installation are working fine under Apache. If this is a brand new server, you can add a test domain and remove it later. Obtaining a license. Now you are ready to install LiteSpeed Web Server. Obtaining a license is optional. It is possible to complete all of the steps in this video with a simple 15-day trial license. Just be aware that once the trial period's over, you'll need to purchase a license in order to continue to use LiteSpeed Web Server. If you need help choosing an appropriate license, see the link in the description. If you'd like to use a trial license, you can skip ahead to the next section of the video. To purchase a LiteSpeed Web Server license, visit store.lightspeedtech.com in your browser. Choose the license that you'd like to purchase and click Order Now. Choose a billing cycle, select a caching product, and click Continue. If you're not sure what type of caching you need, just choose LS Cache Standard, which is included for free in every license. Click Checkout, enter your personal or company details, select a payment method, and click Complete Order. If you don't have a LiteSpeed account, you will create one during checkout. An invoice for your purchase will be sent to your email address. This invoice will include license details, but you may also find the serial number on your account homepage. Look in the Your Active Product/Services section where it says Serial. Copy this to your clipboard since you'll need it for the next step. Installing LiteSpeed Web Server. There are two ways to install LiteSpeed Web Server in a cPanel environment: with or without an options file. We'll show you both, and you can just choose whichever method you prefer. First, we'll demonstrate how to do it without one. Connect to your cPanel environment via SSH and run the get.lightspeed.sh installation script. You can either provide your license serial number or type out the word trial to start a 15-day trial period. We've put the exact commands in the video description in case you'd like to copy them. The installation script will begin by prompting you to answer a few questions. We're not using an options file, so type Y and press Enter to proceed. On the Enable PHP underscore suexec prompt, enter 2 to enable PHP suexec and press Enter. Set the port offset to 1000 and press Enter. Provide an administrator username and email address, and enter 0 to inform the installer that you do not wish to switch PHP handlers. The script will ask whether to switch to LiteSpeed Web Server when the installation completes. Since we've set a port offset, we can run LiteSpeed and Apache at the same time while we test LiteSpeed Web Server. Enter 0 at the prompt. Next, you need to decide whether to automatically scan for WordPress installations and install the cache plugin on all found installations. Enter 1 to allow this or 0 to disallow and press Enter. If you choose to disallow, you can always go back and scan later. Finally, the installer will prompt you to confirm whether to automatically install the LiteSpeed Web Cache Manager User End plugin. This plugin will appear as LiteSpeed Web Cache Manager under the Advanced section on your user's cPanel dashboard. Press 1 to allow or 0 to disallow this and press Enter. When all responses to each prompt have been provided, installation will proceed. When it completes, you will see a success message that includes a randomly generated password for the LiteSpeed Web Admin console. Please save this password in a safe place. Method 2, command line interface with an options file. This method is just like the previous method, except that you don't need to answer the PHP questions manually. Run the nano lsws.options command and then update the installation options. You can copy the exact lines from the video description if you'd like. To save the changes, press Ctrl plus O, press Enter to confirm, and press Ctrl plus X to exit out of the file. Now we can run the get.lightspeed.sh installation script as in the previous method, and it will install the LiteSpeed web server without prompting. Verifying LiteSpeed is running. To verify LiteSpeed's running, navigate to WHM, then Plugins, then LiteSpeed web server. This will confirm that LiteSpeed is running. However, if you see Apache is running instead, find the Switch to LiteSpeed option on that page and click it. You can continue configuring LiteSpeed web server through the LiteSpeed plugin if you'd like. You can set the cache route, switch between LiteSpeed and Apache, manage cache plugin installations across your server, and more. We won't go into detail on that here, but we've made a video that explains everything. Check the description for a link. Congratulations! You have successfully installed LiteSpeed Enterprise in a cPanel environment. If you face any issues with your setup, please see our documentation at docs.lightspeedtech.com or open a support ticket from your client area. Thank you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. See you soon!